Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to make a Barbie makeover. I found this doll in one of my closets. Well, basically I only have two closets, but I found it. And it kind of looks too dirty, don't you think? It's wearing socks, everything. I guess this was when I was little and I played with it so much. Anyways. So, take this sock off and everything. Somehow, I mysteriously got the outside of the cardigan clean, but the rest of this, not exactly. Anyways, take these out, put them right there. Maybe in the trash can. Oops. Okay, so she's naked, and I obviously forgot this. Why do I have tape here? Ta-da! She looks so wonderful, even without stuff. Now, today I'm going to show you how to make a nice little black spy outfit. Without any sleeves. So, here, we got a black, nice little black balloon. Alright, we'll cut it out. My scissors. Like that. Just like so. Then cut the bottom, making a spy outfit, kind of. And she's like, you know. Ooh. Okay, that looks good. Now let's try it on her. But first, we need another small balloon. Cut it out to make some underwear. So I just cut like this part. The rest can make a top. This, I think, is a little bit too low, isn't it? Nah, it's not too low. Anyways, so we're gonna go with this. Okay, guys? And we're gonna... cut it right here. No, wait, right here. And we open it up and we got some underwear. Let's try to put it on her. It doesn't have to fit exactly because under her spy outfit, no one's gonna see. And it doesn't have to be black either, but I just want in case they see her, you know. Bye, ready? Oops, this is backwards. Like so. Push. Sometimes it's easier to put your Barbie upside down. Do this. Done. A little bit too short, but who cares? Maybe not. But it's fine, right? Nobody will see it. That's what it's just for, to hold stuff, too. You know, she's gonna be pretty and comfortable. It's fine. She's gonna be comfortable when she's in this skirt. Down, do stuff, push it in, almost done, she's gonna be the most beautiful spy. Done, finally, oh my gosh. She looks good, but what's missing? The top, right? So here's what we're going to do. The top is going to be black, of course, if I have any more black balloons. But in that case, it'll be dark red. Where's one of my black? We're going to use blue for the puff. But we can use this for the top too, if you want. So you cut it right here. And done. Just like a skirt. She kind of looks like black. I mean, like, cat something. You know, cat noir or something. I forgot. Anyways. So, let's open this up. Well, she doesn't really look like him, but him or her. I never watched that movie, but I know what that girl or boy looks like. Okay. Sometimes she also looks like Batman. So this is going to be a sleeveless shirt. Kind of hard to make a sleeveless shirt out of balloons. Oh, gosh. Oh my, it's working. Let's pull this up. Oh my gosh. Okay, just like so. And she has something sticking out. So here's what we're going to do. We're gonna take this. And the blue one. I'm going to open it up and swoop and make a belt. Just a thin old belt. It's gonna be sleeveless, but with puffs. She's gonna have puffs. She's gonna look like an awesome spy, even though she's not. Ta-da! She looks like she's about to go to the bathroom. Anyways, so she doesn't have shoes because, and I have no idea why she does not have shoes, but I'm going to ask her some shoes later. So we're going to take these balloons. Okay, I don't need a stick. Anyways, so we're going to cut two. Right in the middle to these puffs, just like so, and then cut them in half. Ooh, wow, she's gonna look like an awesome spy from balloons. Anyways, so let's add this into a puff. Blah, blah. Ooh. And let's put them a little bit shorter to match with the outfit. Oh my god. She looks absolutely wonderful. Let's add another one. Let's add another one. Okay. I obviously made that up. Okay, so we're going to put it. It's kind of hard on this one because her hand is curved and I don't want it to be curved. But mom or mother, whatever, however you call your mother or mom or anything, and brought it when I was really little. So, you know. Oh my. Okay. Next. We're going to take this. Okay. Alright. Almost as black. And we're going to cover her hair with it. So we're just going to go like this. careful. But first, we just take out her boring ponytail. Then, okay, let's cut this just like so. And we're going to use that other piece for another craft to make her cardigan so she doesn't get cold while being a detective spy. She's not really a spy though. Anyways, just like being a spy for Halloween. Oh my gosh. Okay, she's going to have a face mask. Ta-da! Going to have a face mask and she can't see us. Put holes for her eyes. Here's one. Try it on. Oh my goodness. Oh my. Oops, this is gonna be hard. Maybe not for her eye, but for her whole entire face. Okay, so I open this. Maybe even bigger this time. Ooh. So she can pull her hair back while hiding in the bushes. Ta-da! Okay. Now, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to take this black. Cut it like this. And not like this, obviously. I'm gonna have to make another one. Okay, she doesn't look like a superhero anymore, but that's fine. I don't want her to be a superhero anyways. I want her to be a spy for Halloween. Go. Hold this back in place. Sorry if I sniffle a little bit too much. Had that allergies. Oh. Anyways. So, we're going to take a red ribbon. Ooh. Not a red ribbon, red balloon. Very big, right? Put like that. But one point pointing, and let's put it on one, only one of her hands. You know why? Because she's gonna scare the monster. Okay, not the monster, obviously, the criminal. Been thinking too much from all my reading in my school, so, kind of hilarious. Read the Wings of Fire ones, and kind of, yeah. Okay, these four fingers are going to help her touch hot stuff, despite her thumb. Wow, she is looking nice here. Anyways, take this red old ribbon, tie it as a scarf around her neck. But we're going to, instead of making a scarf, we're going to cross it. And go like this. And tie it at the back. Double tying it, please. So it won't fall off while she's chasing the criminal. There we go. And put it a little bit lower. And oh my, now she can put her stuff inside. just gonna need a whip and other stuff that I will let her decide. But maybe she doesn't need a whip, but we can use it for as a decoration. Just hook it through like that. See? And tie it. Not double tying it. Tying it. Tying it. Dip it up. Oops. Done. Oh my. See, looks good. Cadigan. Here I go. It's going to be a turtleneck cadigan. Well, not even a cadigan. It's like a cape. Looks just like that. And we're going to put her on like this. Just took her on a minute. Not working. If this doesn't work, then just make a regular cadigan. Just like do like that, but without the neck, and then cut two triangles. That's it. How you make a cadigan. Cadigan, cadigan, here I go. Out of my eye. Okay, here she comes, Detective Spy. Now she's going to have some resistant, what's it called again? Boots. So, one, not this one. Here's one. And another I need. Maybe there, two. And we're going to cut them and put them on her. She's going to look like a beautiful, gentle, and kind detective spy for Halloween. Right, because she's not an actual spy, right? Let's cut this. Done. Open this up. Oh my, no more pie. Where's that guy? Well, somebody found the trash can. Yep, they found the trash can. Anyways, because I have the trash can right next to me, let's try to put always, right? If you're in a working room, then you always need a trash can next to you, because if you're going crafting and there's like stuff that you need to throw out and like billions of stuff I need. And you need to throw them out. You gotta go and throw them out. Ooh, here's one of her beautiful spy socks. I'm gonna call them boots. Okay? Since spy socks are not a thing. Have you ever saw a spy on the internet or in real life that is wearing spy socks? No, never, right? And that's not even a thing, I think. Let's wear this on. Oh my, no more pie. Pie's too sweet. I want a piece of meat. Meat's still red. I want a piece of bread. Oops, that went flinging across the room. It's fine. Okay, now we're going to take some cardboard. If you guys have one, Then just use strong paper. Okay, here's some cardboard. Cut very thin strip, but kind of long. Into equal. Just like so. Ta-da! You mark where you're gonna cut it. And cut it a little bit forward so you can do that sole and cut it like this. See? And then take some glue. Here you go, detective. And I think I'm just going to go like this. Bend that a little bit. Just a little bit. I'm telling you, just a little bit to let her walk. Keep gluing. I have to put my foot up. Yes, not some injury, but I can still make videos, right? Done. Fabulous. Kind of working. Nah, it's not working. Maybe she's gonna have some spy socks after all. Maybe not. But this looks horrible on her. Maybe she's going to have spy socks. And she's going to look like Batman and Batgirl. Despite the red and blue. I don't know if Batman has blue or red, but I never watch that movie. I never watch any movies. Anyways, so fabulous. Next, we're going to take just a thin straw. Obviously a straw that I already cut, and color it black. Here she goes, just color it black. I'm using a whiteboard marker. Oomph. Blue eyes. Did black. Just like so. Nice. And cut through. Put your scissors like that. And then put a little like that. And then cut. And let's open it up a kind of a little bit. And there's white inside. And put it on the spy detective's hands. I'm gonna call her Detective Susie. That means we have to write Susie on her shirt. Susie. Susie. See? Alright, I'll write. Susie Spy. Great. And she has that cuff around her hand. And we're going to color it white, representing spy, writing an S. Well, maybe not an S, but a stripe through. Done, just a stripe through. See? and waiting for it to dry. And write F. There we go. S for Susie and Susie Spy. Ta-da! Still have an interview. Hello, I am Susie Spy. Anyways, so that's her thing. And first, her hair looks like a bird's nest. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to take a nice little bumper band. She's almost done with her Detective Spy clothes. Except for her hair. Anyway, open it up and cling it into a low ponytail. Nobody's gonna see her, but it's kind of But what if they see her? Okay, ta-da, Susie, Detective Spy, cuckoo. Okay, and we're done with this awesome Susie Spy makeover. I'll see you next time at the next video. And I'm gonna lift this shirt up and ta-da! How wonderful does she look? If you think she looks wonderful or you like my video, click on the like at the bottom below or click the subscribe button and I'll see you next time. Bye!